If you are working with Deno and you are not using NPM specifiers, you are really missing out. Let me explain. Back when Deno was fresh out of the oven, everyone relied on HTTP imports through services like esm.sh or unpackage.com to pull in NPM packages. That worked well enough for quick experiments, but the cracks showed up fast. Imports through these services cannot guarantee that different packages use the same version of shared dependencies, which leads to duplicated modules and subtle bugs. For example, if you import React and React DOM from different sources, you might end up with two different React instances in memory, which causes components to break in unpredictable ways. On top of that, many NPM packages need to run install hooks to build native add-ons. HTTP imports don't support install hooks at all, so these packages fail silently or throw confusing errors. But this all changes thanks to native NPM support in Deno, which lets you import packages directly using NPM specifiers. When you do this, Deno understands your dependency versions semantically, just like Node does, and it makes sure there's only one copy of each dependency in your module graph. So you won't run into mysterious bugs from duplicate packages or mismatched versions, your imports stay clean, and your app behaves the same way every time you run it. Using NPM specifiers also unlocks install hooks, so packages that need to compile native code or set up important files during installation will actually work. Deno will run these installed scripts if you grant permission with the allow scripts flag, but it won't just do it behind your back. It shows a clear prompt so you know exactly when and why something wants to run on your machine. This adds a much-needed layer of security that's missing from traditional Node installs. Another big win is how Deno handles data files in NPM packages. Packages often include non-code assets like fonts, JSON data, or text files that they rely on at runtime. If you're using HTTP imports, those files don't always make it through, which leads to weird, hard-to-track errors when your app tries to load something that isn't there. Native NPM imports solve this by downloading the full package, including all required assets, so everything works the way the package author intended. On top of all that, Deno doesn't need a Node modules folder when you use NPM imports in scripts without a package.json file. Your dependencies are cached globally, so you avoid bloating your project with thousands of files you don't actually need to see or touch. Your directory stays clean and focused on your own code. However, if you do need a package.json for compatibility, Deno still supports it, but for many cases, you can skip it completely and share your script as a single file. But probably the biggest gain is on the security front, since native NPM support in Deno is a massive improvement over the Node ecosystem. Every time a dependency tries to access the file system, network, or other sensitive resources, Deno makes you explicitly allow it. There is no silent access like in Node, where a rogue package can do whatever it wants. So if you are still using URLs and HTTP imports in your Deno project, it's time to move forward. Switch to NPM specifiers, use Deno's native NPM support, and you'll get reliable dependency resolution, fewer surprises, and a safer development environment that makes building and sharing Deno programs a lot easier. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to keep up with all the amazing goodies we are preparing for you, and until next time, thanks for watching!